David Silka.
I'm not going to read my letter because I think it's too case specific, and I've taken your comments about being able to investigate specific cases and stuff here. But I was in Manhattan earlier today, and I found out about this meeting. I drove up to get here on time because I did want to present a situation. So I guess the way I would phrase it more generally is, urge you to investigate the issue of for-profit supervision. In my office agreement in 2005, I agreed to a limited set of supervised visits because my ex-wife would be insisting on it. And if I was appointed to be quote-unquote the gatekeeper, who was going to transition me to a unsupervised relationship with my children as soon as possible. Well, when the supervisor, after many, many months, I was told it would be about a dozen sessions that I would prove myself that I didn't need supervision. Started writing that it wasn't necessary, and I was going to go and break down and all that. First of all, he allowed my ex-wife's attorney completely bent his head to changing his recommendation. The gatekeeper did nothing. Instead, just continuing. The guy from Elijah as well just turned a blind eye. Since then, my divorce and actual supervision started before. I spent $1.5 million on supervision and the divorce. Whenever anyone sends an email, it goes to 8 people, which is $150 an hour. I think my children are being essentially divorced. And when I hired Attorney Patterson, who took the case because he said he never heard anything like it, this same gatekeeper canceled my right to see my kids. I haven't seen him since then. He basically retaliated against my children and me. Just to give you an idea of what the supervisor said when he was recommending that it end, I just do want to read this because it just shows you how crazy this thing is. He wrote to everybody, "I can truly say that I've not often seen this type of connection between the father," and that's his emphasis, "and his children that I see in David when he's with Chloe and Jake. I wish that I could have had that connection with any one of my own crew," by which he means his adopted children. Within a week, the gatekeeper and the guardian of Elijah had commented about clandestine meetings between my ex-wife's attorney and the supervisor that should not be happening. That's a quote, clandestine meetings is what the gatekeeper called them. Totally changed his opinion. Nobody questioned his change of opinion. I told you about the body since then. And then this brazen of retaliation against me and my children. When I hired an attorney, I'd like to just give you the data point about that too, because it's also, I think, instructive. It seems as if there was communication between the attorney and the gatekeeper the very day that he canceled my visits. His records show that they were talking. We believe that she told him, "Hey, it's Patterson, so everyone careful." He asked to be identified. 3 minutes after he asked to be identified, the ex-wife was telling him identified. Clearly there was, I don't think that's a coincidence, not as a turned out. When we refused to identify him, that's when he cancelled the business. There's a racket going on. You know, children are being held hostage to a great train of supervisors, gatekeepers, guardian ad litem, child therapists. I'd just like to mention one thing. My wife, I believe my wife's intention is to completely guard the relationship between me and my children. She's remarried and so on. When my mother, who we have a very close family, you know, like meeting my cousin, ladies and so forth, when my mom wanted to see her kids this summer, the children's therapist said she could see her grandchildren if she didn't mention me or any of their cousins, or show any pictures of any family members. I have a sister and 7 siblings and sisters. She wasn't allowed to show any pictures or even mention any of the children's cousins or their father or mother. And that was the condition of her seeing her grandchildren. It's disgusting. It's completely disgusting. I would love one of you to take up my case. I heard that you can't investigate cases, but you know, I'm doing my best not to investigate cases. I want to see my kids. I was denied seeing them this weekend. Again, the email sent by the gatekeeper, he's still in the case. He CC'd 8 people, you know? to know that I can tell my kids. It's just disgusting. The whole for-profit thing is totally compromised. It's sick. And people who are suffering like me, my children, as well as people, but no one seems to care much about fathers. But at least the children, and I know you guys will care. Thanks.
Thank you.